रहमान रहीम, आई इनवाइट द ऑनरेबल प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द इस्लामिक रिपब्लिक ऑफ पाकिस्तान मिस्टर आसिफ अली जरदारी टू एड्रेस अंडर क्लॉज 3 ऑफ आर्टिकल 56 ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ द इस्लामिक रिपब्लिक ऑफ पाकिस्तान बोथ हाउसेज ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट असेंबल टुगेदर.
बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम. चेयरमैन सेनेट सैयद यूसुफ रजा गिलानी, स्पीकर ऑफ द नेशनल असेंबली सरदार अयाज सादिक, प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ पाकिस्तान मोहम्मद शहबाज शरीफ, मेंबर्स ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट, डिस्टिंग्विश्ड गेस्ट, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, अस्सलाम वालेकुम. As we embark upon the first parliamentary year, let me extend my heartfelt congratulations to all honourable members of the Parliament on the election to this august house. I would also like to compliment the Prime Minister and both federal and provincial governments on their election victories and assumption of their responsibilities. Let me also take this opportunity to express my sincerest gratitude to all parliamentarians and provincial assembly members for their trust and confidence in electing me for a second time as the President of Islamic Republic of Pakistan. I am humbled by this opportunity to bestowed upon me by the grace of Almighty Allah. Mr. Speaker, let me begin this parliamentary year by sharing briefly my vision for future, because much of it's based on choices we make in my particular role in the past too. I have made important choices that made history. When I chose to give away my own powers as president to the Parliament of Pakistan, I expect you as parliamentarians to use those powers with the wisdom and maturity our country merits and needs. I see my own role today as a unifying symbol of a joint, robust federation where all people and provinces should be treated in equal before law. At the same time, in my considered view, it is time to turn a new page. If we see today as a new beginning, which it is, that we can build on by investing in our people, by focusing on public needs, by harnessing our relation of our resources to create pathways to inclusive growth. I also feel that we have little time to waste. The country needs us to move on from the polarization so common now to contemporary politics. This joint house must play a leading role in the rebuilding public confidence in the parliamentary process and establish a foundation for the uninterrupted sustainable development of our nation. Let us not confuse constructive disagreement and healthy noises of a growing democracy with a pursuit of zero-sum thinking. The country needs us to take pause and reflect on what we prioritize in our goals, our narratives, and our agendas. I believe we can resist the political atmosphere to reflect more light than heat if we really want to. but it will need all of us to step back and decide what matters the most. I mean all of us. At the end of the day, it is up to all of us to turn challenges into opportunities, because that is what robust nations do. I have always drawn inspiration, guidance from great leaders such as Qaid Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah, Shahid Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto, Shahid Mohtarma Benazir Bhutto, who spend their lives being advocates for democracy, tolerance and social justice. I firmly believe that by embracing the vision of these leaders, we can effectively tackle our challenges and foster an atmosphere of mutual respect and political reconciliation. The challenges we face are not impossible to overcome. They just require a fundamental of meaningful dialogues, parliamentary consensus, and a timeline implementation of rigorous reforms aimed at addressing underlying issues, both old and new, confronting us. I strongly believe that in order to align our country with the 21st century, it is imperative that we move forward on reforms to promote good governance for the provision of optimal social entitlement to our citizens. Let's begin with a vision that strives to leave no one behind, for this thought to move beyond an idea. The political leadership gathering in this House must prioritize the specific needs for marginalized communities and underdeveloped areas. By focusing on the needs of these regions, we can bridge the gap between them and the more developed areas of the country, moving the needle towards an inclusive growth model that emphasizes equality of opportunities. While there are many economic reforms the government will drive in pursuing jobs, reducing inflation, and expanding the tax net, I want to underscore the importance of promoting positive working relationship and effective coordination within our constitutional framework between the federal government and the provinces. This is an absolute essential for promoting an inclusive national development agenda.